Greetings, Eric Packer, naturopath from New Zealand. Question today, my stool pH is low. Is this, what does this mean? Is it too acidic? Is it candida? What is it? So let's have a look at stool pH. So we often get stool test results back. I got one here back from a patient, for example. We'll just cover over the patient's name. So this is a typical stool test here. In fact, this patient here, interestingly, has, look at that, candida kefir from having too much kefir in the diet. So kefir can also create a candida problem, so watch out. So this patient's stool pH is too low. It's 5.6, I think. We'll explain exactly what that means in a minute. Yeah, so this patient's stool pH, you can see here, is 5.7, okay? So we're just dealing with over, where are we? We're dealing with this number over here. So the stool pH ideally should be, I think around 6 to about 7.8 is about the average stool pH. So when the stool pH is too low, it usually means a problem. And when it's too high, it means a problem. So low will mean too acidic, of course, and too high will mean too alkaline. So beneficial bacteria in your digestive system, particularly the bifida species and the lactobacillus species, they generate a lot of these acids called short-chain fatty acids. And these really help to ferment different fibers, undigested fibers in the colon. And this will actually start adjusting the pH of the bowel. So if you've got a rapid transit time, like if the stool passes through too quick, the pH will be too low. If you've got constipation, it can be a little bit too high. Antibiotic use, for example, or killing off a lot of bacteria in the bowel, good bacteria, will elevate the pH of the stool. Candida can be associated with low pH or high pH, depending really on the types of beneficial bacteria that you've got in the bowel, and also whether there are parasites there or other kinds of bacteria, like citrobacter, for example, or pseudomonas. If these guys are way too high, that's going to throw the pH out as well. People with poor stomach or pancreatic function can also have problems with their pH because they're not digesting foods properly, which means they're not going to really get, you know, a proper fermentation in the colon, which in the large bowel, which will affect the pH of the stool again. So when the pH of the stool is way too low or way too high, it can also push you more towards inflammatory diseases of the bowel and even cancer. So it's important to keep the pH between 6 to about 7.8. Foods do influence the pH of the stool to a degree too, but more so chewing and stress, and you know, good food selection is very important. Having a can of Coke and chicken McNuggets is not going to give you a really good stool pH, is it? So having a hamburger and a cigarette and a cold beer is probably going to cause problems with your tummy if you keep eating like that long term. Eating broccoli and maybe some lean chicken or some salmon is a more sensible choice, because you've got better foods there in terms of the fermentation capability, which means you're going to have a much better bowel function. Food is medicine. Medicine is food. Think about it. So I hope that answers the question a little bit about stool pH. It's governed very much by what you eat and how you eat. And candida certainly can be influenced to a high degree by pH as well. Because having a good stool pH is going to discourage the growth of candida in the digestive tract and encourage the proliferation of beneficial bacteria. Thanks for tuning in.